Shelters, maybe you think of dogs and cats or, I don't know, something else, but these little guys need some help too. And Samantha Blickensdurfer is the founder of These Little Guinea Critters Rescue, right?
These Little Guineas.
Okay, yep. These Little Guineas here. She's here along with shelter volunteer Emma. So how did you guys come up with this idea? Was there a need that you saw that you needed to attend to?
Yeah, essentially, I've had small animals, rabbits and guinea pigs since I was little. And a couple years ago, one of my friends suggested it to me. And at the time I was like, that's a wild idea.
Yeah.
Like, why would I do that? But I figured I'd post an ad, and I did. And,
and you found out there's a need there.
Yeah.
Do people abandon the animals, or they don't want them anymore and they don't know what to do? And they
All of our animals are owner surrendered.
Like
people tend to get animals that they don't realize how much work they are. And so then after a while they get tired of it, and then they bring them to
Every
us.
Every kid wants a nice little critter like this.
Who's
this person?
This is Athos. He's our hamster, one of our three hamsters at the shelter. He was actually at a pet store that was closing, and I went to get some discounted supplies. And the lady asked me if I would take him and his brothers, and I said, yeah, we have room at the shelter, so.
But that's not how it all started.
No.
Okay. What was your first animal? Emma, and have you been there from the beginning?
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
What was the first animal?
Guinea pigs.
Yeah, wasn't it? Yeah, it was guinea pigs.
Yeah, we.
The name. Okay.
Yeah, we started out with the guinea pigs, and slowly we saw that it wasn't just guinea pigs who needed help. It was all these small animals. So.
Who else do you have? Because it's not just this little guy. What's it? Athos.
Yeah.
Athos.
Yep.
Okay.
So
who else?
We also have some guinea pigs.
Be careful now.
Oh, I know. I'm getting hay everywhere.
Oh my! You're a little bit bigger, aren't you?
So this is Lola, and
Lola.
We have her sister. Would you like to hold her?
Okay. I've never held a guinea pig. Hello.
You're doing great.
Hello, Lola.
You want to hold her butt.
Okay.
And we have Ginger, who is her sister.
Oh, family members here.
Yeah. Wow. So they're not litter mates, but they are sisters. They're paired
Say
together.
Hello to you haven't seen each other in a while. So are both of these up for adoption, or how does that work?
All the animals that we have are up for adoption right now. We have 87 animals up for adoption.
Yes.
So, really what we require is a photo of the cage setup that you have, and you have to come out and do a meet and greet with us to make sure that we like you and the animals like you.
I hear her.
Yeah.
They
make lots of noises, yes. But yeah, if you come out to the shelter, or if you message me to set up a time, you can come out and meet the animals and maybe take one home.
Emma, what does it look like in the facility? I'm trying to get an idea. Is this do you do this out of your home? Do you do this
isn't it? It's like in a garage.
Okay.
So
it's a really big barn.
It's a really big.
And how do you guys, how are you getting financial support to do this? Because this is not cheap, right? You do it on your own?
We get donations. It's definitely not enough to cover all the expenses. We just had a $400 vet bill that we're trying to pay off. So from day one, I've kind of financed most of it myself. It's my passion, and I'm happy to do so.
Well, if you'd like to join these young ladies here in joining the passion, we've got more information about these little guineas, Critter Rescue. They're adoptable pets, how you can help. Hopefully you get the word out and maybe get more in your community here. Fox59.com in the link section. You want to hang out some more? You good? Yeah? Okay. All right. So, Jim, there you go. We first guinea pig I've ever held.
Yeah.